Okay, let's take up a problem which we would like to, which we'll solve using these relationships. And so you have here all these activities A to H. When we say predecessor, it means A. Okay, so for B, predecessor is A with a finish start with a lag of 4, and the duration of B is 7. Okay, so what I want you to do first is draw the PDM. Okay, once you draw the PDM, we will see. I'll show you what network we have, and then go ahead and start doing the analysis.
Sir, there A start in the FA relationship. Start to finish is there now.
Which one?
F and A. F, A is predecessor.
A is a predecessor?
Yeah. Their start to finish means A start to F finish.
Yes. Yeah. F can finish 15, there's a 15 days lag. Okay?
After A starts.
After A starts.
The AF relations, what is there? F finishes first. No, A will finish after F finishes.
There's no finish relationship. A will start. Hmm. F can finish only 15 days after A starts. Okay, and when we are talking about ABCD projects and says, you know, finish start or start finish, it's not, I mean, it's just a little bit of a kind of a twist in the way you think. But when you get into the real world and try to actually put something in a finish, a start finish mode, it's quite complex. Okay, we'll do the analysis. Okay, I want you to make sure, I mean, is your first is the representation. Representation's okay. Any questions on the representation? Okay, so we now do the forward pass, the analysis goes on. So this is the, okay, early start, early finish. This becomes 9 because?
Finish start.
Finish. Yeah, this is a finish start with a lag. Yes. Okay, goes to 16. Here we start this at 5. Okay, 11, 5 plus 6, 11. This is normal finish start, so 16, 23. Now here this is a start. See, okay, so E has two options. Okay, right now it's going 5 plus 2 is 7. E also has a 16. Okay, the second, so 7, 17, 16, 26. Okay, so the 16 is the max. So 16, 26 takes the is the values which we consider. Now, okay, I'm going back on this. So here is the start finish relationship. A has started on 0, F can finish by
15.
Okay, now how do I calculate the early start of F?
Minus 30.
Minus 30. 2. Okay, if by some chance F, say if duration of F was more than 15, what would it mean?
Then we have to extend 0, put 0.
In the yeah, so A would have had to start on, I mean, if you want to be on a reasonable calendar, A would have to start on a positive, not on a 0. Okay, so here we say F has to start at 2. Now we move on to, so G, there's no, so G is going here, actually this, there's no arrow here, it's a 27. 24, and then we finally come down here, all of these are at 27, 35, these are the options we have. Okay, 15, 23, 26, 34, okay, and 27, 35 is the option we select. So this has taken care of the forward pass. Now coming into the backward pass. Okay, we have the 35, 27. Okay, we take 27, 24. We bring here 27. Okay, we carry out 27 here. 14. 14. 27. 17. Okay, now going back here, we have to go with the 27. It's going to be go back to 23 and 16. Now here we had 17, okay, going with this, going back on the start with a lag of 2 relationship, we come to 15,
21,
okay, and 21. Now here we have 2 options, we had 16 and we have 17, so we have 17 10 or 16 9 minimum 16 10. Now we come down to A, okay, three paths, 3 options.
0 and 5.
Okay, so it's 0 and 5. Yeah.
This relationship for A to
A. What is your, so what this means is that see, 15 days after A starts, only F can finish. I'm giving it to you as a logical relationship. I'm not trying to put a situation in which this can happen. I'm just telling you this is the logical, and I explained earlier that this is not a common situation. So we are only doing it for the logic in the network. Okay. Any questions? Okay. So you can see that when you do the analysis as compared to an AON. You have to be very careful as to how you go back and forth on relationships, and you will find in this particular case, so what is critical?
A B D G H.
Okay, and in the next lecture we will see how the criticality is not sometimes the start or the end. So you know it can be, for example, in this particular case, if we can change duration like we discussed earlier, it is only the finish of G that is critical, right. The start of G is not on the critical path, so to say, but because duration is, we are holding the duration as continuous days, the start is becoming pulled in with the finish. Any other questions? But so dealing with this complexity is supposed to give us a lot of advantages of flexibility. So the trade-off between flexibility and complexity is where some people find, yes, the complexity is okay, it gives me, it really represents my project with minimum number of activities and I am able to use it properly. Many others find that no, I rather go back to finish start, activity on node, and I am able to do my, I can understand my project more intuitively with that. Okay, so these are 2 schools of practice which we continually keep discussing and debating. Now we come to this question which was raised, what if an activity does not have to be continuous? Okay, so here we have, this is very similar to our earlier example of excavation, laying pipe and backfilling. So you can see these values which you have gone through. And here we are saying that, so here with 0 to 10, and so this is the forward pass, these values give the backward, I am not getting into the detail. And as discussed earlier, if for example, what does this mean? This means, okay, what is the critical path here? Let us look through. A starts at 10, A starts at 0, finishes at 10, okay, B starts at 4 based on the start of A. Okay, and it right now it goes all the way to 19. Okay, what if I, and C starts at 8 based on the start of B and goes all the way to 38. Okay, why should B finish at 19? Should A start at 4? For the project to finish, so project duration is 38. I don't want to stop. I don't want to change the project duration. If A doesn't start at 4, what happens?
But early start means it's the earliest it can start, no, sir.
Right.
So 4th ray is the earliest it can start.
Right. What if A starts at 5? What happens to the project?
Project gets delayed, but it's not the earliest start. Like the name resembles earliest start.
Earliest start. No. What is the earliest B can start? Yeah, I can't start B before 4, right?
Yeah.
What if I start B after 4?
Then
project gets delayed. So start of B is critical. Let me go to the end of B. Okay, and now we are taking away this continuous activity. Let me go to the end of B. End of B is not critical.
It can end at
34. Right. Do all of you see that? So in my AON, if an activity start was critical, end was critical, because my only the finish start went through the activity. Here my relationships don't necessarily go through the activity. They go with the start and with the end of the activity. So I can have situations where the starting an activity is critical, and if I'm willing to delay or to change the duration, the end does not necessarily become critical. Yeah.
Actually, early start and early finish, those meaning, sir, what is the earliest it can start, what is the earliest it can finish?
Right.
19th is the day earliest it can finish, but it can continue until 34. So ideally project can continue until 34.
The project can continue. What we are trying to do is a comparison between this and activity on node. Okay, so if we did this, what do you say that, so we, in this case, if we assumed activity on node and there was float on it, when I start floating an activity, what happens? So here, do you realize the start has no float, the finish has float? Okay, so that is what we are trying to kind of understand here. I agree with your definitions, but here is an activity where the start has no float but the finish has float. Okay, so the definition, this definition becomes valid only when I can stretch an activity, or I can say I'm going to be doing it in parts. If I have to finish it continuously, then we are back to the kind of AON kind of definition. Okay, so the original precedence diagramming method was designed with this in mind, so that we could make use of starts and ends as separate events. And we could then try to get the best of the activity on arrow technique, which had start and end as separate events, and the activity on node technique, which was more intuitive to understand. Okay, now again, like I said before, the judgment is on the practitioners. Some practitioners are okay with this. There are many practitioners which say, I would still rather use only activity on node and finish start, because that's much more intuitive for me to.
There is a lot more flexibility in this approach.
But when you have thousands of activities and very many types of relationships, in addition to the algorithm being flexible and giving you a lot more room for decision making, you have to be sure the representation is accurate. And that is where this runs into issues. And even the way the algorithm, like I discussed, the algorithm is implemented in different packages. You need a package to be able to do this professionally. It varies. Okay, so for example, Microsoft Project will not allow you to do multiple relationships like this. Primavera will allow you to do multiple relationships. Okay, so Microsoft Project says, no, I don't want you to deal with the complexity of this, I only want single relationship. But then in the process, you remember what happened. We land up with dangling activities and other kinds of problems, which you have to overcome then by putting dummy activities. Okay, so this was the state of the art, you know, as of the version 10 or what. Now, whether they're going to change it or not, we don't know. So this is the uncertainty which PDM causes, and there's a lot of discussion on it. And in fact, the people who originally developed PDM says it's been used in such non-standardized ways that it's probably time to come up and develop a standard for PDM, which doesn't exist. Okay, so we will discuss more on these issues as we get into the tools and its packages. So if we do a comparison between the two, this, we know this allows only one kind of relationship. This, the PDM allows three additional types. Okay, here we know the preceding activity must be completed before any succeeding activity can start. Here you have you know, lags and leads which you can add. Cannot create complex schedules, it's easy to interpret. Can, you know, it can be used flexible. There's a lot of flexibility at, you know, the complexity can be addressed by the flexibility, but sometimes it's not easy to interpret. Okay, so I will give you this problem and we will solve it in the next class, but this is something which I would like you to work on. Okay.